Hey everyone, I'm Neha from India Hikes and you've tuned into Tech Pro Tips with Neha. In today's video, I'm going to tell you 8 winter accessories that you absolutely must carry on your trek. I've been getting a lot of slope updates that trekkers are forgetting these accessories. So today I'm going to tell you what these 8 winter accessories are. I'll start from the head, go all the way down to the toes so that we don't forget anything. Let's get started. The first thing that you need is a woolen cap. Now, I've seen a lot of times trekkers roaming around their campsites and they have all their layers on. They have their padded jackets, their shoes, their socks, their fingers are covered with gloves, but they still feel cold. And that's because they don't have their heads covered. Now, you lose a lot of heat from your head, which is why your woolen cap is extremely important. It will help you keep really warm. My pro tip for you would be to get ones with slight extensions so that your ears are covered because they tend to get quite icy cold. The second thing that you need is a sun cap. Now, a lot of trekkers think that during the winter season you don't need one and that this is only for the summer season, but that's actually far from the truth. During winter, when you're on a trek, the sun is quite harsh and there are times when you feel like the sun is beating down on you. So you need a sun cap. This is something that will protect you from the sun, and I have 2 pro tips for you here. One, when you buy a sun cap, if you're able to get one that has flaps on the side, then your neck is also covered. So that's a good way of keeping yourself protected from the sun. The second thing is that wear the sun cap when you're on your trek. The moment you reach the campsite, because you're still quite warm, make sure you quickly switch to the woolen cap. So that way you're retaining your body's heat and you'll be warm throughout the night. Next on the list is a headlamp. Now, a headlamp is extremely important because on all treks, when you go on the summit, you have to start early in the morning. You leave around maybe 4 or 5 in the morning, much before sunrise. So it's going to be dark, you'll need some source of light. And rather than having something like a mobile torch in your hand, having a headlamp is very handy. That way both your hands are free, you can use your trek poles comfortably. If you need to clamber onto a rock or something, you have your hands free for that. So make sure you carry this. This is something a lot of trekkers forget. So have that with you. The next thing that you need is a pair of sunglasses. Now, sunglasses are perhaps one of the most forgotten things, but it is actually the most important on a winter trek. And I'll tell you why. When you're going on a winter trek, you'll have most of your trail covered with snow. And as you know, snow is a reflective surface. So it's almost like you're staring into the sun as you're climbing up. So I want to tell you here that just 30 to 40 minutes of exposure to this can damage your cornea and cause snow blindness, and you don't want that on a trek. Even though the effect is temporary, it's quite painful and disconcerting. So every time you see snow, make sure you have these glasses on you. Moving on from the head to the neck, the next thing that you'll need is a balaclava or a neck warmer. Now, don't underestimate the power of a neck warmer because the neck can get quite sensitive. It's sensitive to cold. You want to have this around your neck, maybe even pulling it up to your nose and keeping this part warm. So along with the head and your fingers covered, this will keep you super warm. I'd recommend a fleece one. You can also use a scarf instead of a balaclava. But the thing about the scarf that I don't like is that it's hanging around your neck. So I don't want anything here when I'm trekking. But if you are using it, use a woolen one. It'll keep you much warmer than a regular scarf. Next, I'm going to be talking about extremities, which are basically your hands and your fingertips. Now, the winter accessory that you need for this is a pair of synthetic hand gloves. This is very important, and I want to emphasize here that you need to have synthetic ones because you're on a winter trek. This means that you'll be handling snow, you'll be touching snow, and this will get wet. So having something that dries very quickly, keeps you dry from inside, is very important. A pro tip that I can give you is that when you buy these gloves, make sure you have a fleece inner lining because that keeps you a lot warmer. Just like with the head, the extremities is another place from where the body heat escapes quite easily, and that's why having these gloves on at all times is very important. Moving on from our hands to our feet, I'm going to talk about socks now. Now, along with your regular polyester socks that you'll be using when you go trekking, I also want you to have a pair of woolen socks with you. This is very important. I want you to have it only when you are sleeping. Right before you get into your sleeping bag, put these on. Make sure you remove your polyester socks before that. The reason I'm asking you to have a separate pair of woolen socks is because the polyester ones tend to get really wet because you'll be trekking in snow, and chances are, no matter how waterproof your shoes are, that you will get a little wet. So these pair of woolen socks will be a lifesaver for you. They'll keep you warm throughout the night. This brings me to the last and final winter accessory that most trekkers forget. That's rainwear. Now this is super important because a lot of trekkers I see, they kind of bank on their padded jacket to keep them dry. But these jackets are going to work only in mild rain or when there's light snowfall. But when it gets heavier, you will need proper rain wear. My pro tip for you though would be to have not just a poncho but actually rain pants and rain jacket. That gives you more mobility and it really works when you're trekking. So make sure you have good rain wear when you go on your trek. So these are the 8 winter accessories that I want you to take on your winter trek. Make sure you don't forget any of them. If you're going in a group or with friends, share this video with them so none of you forget these winter accessories that will come in handy. Most of them are available on our rental store, so make sure you check out the link in the description below. And also follow us on Facebook, Instagram and Twitter. We're constantly posting live updates from our slopes, our trekking world. Also, if you want to watch more such videos on trekking gear and winter treks, then be sure to subscribe to our channel and click on the bell icon next to it so that you get notified the next time we make a video. Thank you.